the Cowboys were calling, but they were trying to make an offer, but we never even got into the talks of the offer or numbers or anything of that sort, you know. Right when I saw the Saints offer, and you know, I talked to Sean Payton and I told him I wanted to be the Saint, we made it happen. I was just ecstatic. I didn't even care to answer any more calls from anybody. I knew where I wanted to be.
That's Emmanuel Sanders. And this one kind of came out of the blue last Friday night. There were some talks about Emmanuel Sanders drawing interest from the Dallas Cowboys, Chris. And then just boom, he's agreed to terms with the Saints. That's how the smart teams do it. Not that the Cowboys aren't smart, but you keep it quiet. You don't let anyone, especially if the Saints, if it gets out the Saints are on to Emmanuel Sanders, that's the kind of thing that's going to wake up other teams. Because, like, hey, if Sean Payton sees something in this guy, other teams are going to get in the mix. Other teams are going to throw more money on the table. Maybe the Cowboys accelerate their pursuit. But it was kind of stealth mode for Sean Payton. He got it done. And, man, this one makes a lot of sense for the Saints. When you've got Michael Thomas, who set a single-season record for receptions, and they really don't have a solid, obvious, clear number two, all of a sudden, Emmanuel Sanders becomes that guy, and he's going to have a lot of favorable matchups because everybody's trying to stop Michael Thomas.
No doubt about it. I mean, it's a perfect fit for both guys, for both. I mean, it's perfect for the Saints. It's perfect for Emmanuel Sanders, a guy that's getting up there in age. He's not necessarily going to be the guy that can beat you on a go route or a post route for 60 or 70 yards, you know, consistently anymore, but he's a really good route runner. He understands defenses. He's a veteran. He's been around other great quarterbacks. It's a perfect system fit. And then to your point, Mike, you're right. I mean, Michael Thomas is so the go-to guy in that Saints offense. And if I remember correctly, it's the biggest disparity between the number one receiver on the team compared to the number two receiver in all of football. Well, this will close that gap. And Emmanuel Sanders will be able to do some of the things over the middle that Michael Thomas does. And now Sean Payton can move Michael Thomas outside and command double coverage with him or just create a mismatch with both of these guys. So you talk about Emmanuel Sanders, Michael Thomas, Jared Cook, and then Alvin Kamara coming out of the backfield. Damn, that's pretty good for Drew Brees and Sean Payton. They can be very creative with that crew right there.
And even though the 49ers gave up a third-round pick and a fourth-round pick and ultimately got 10 regular season games out of Emmanuel Sanders, Kendrick Bourne spoke to Matt Maiocco of NBC Sports Bay Area earlier this week and explained the impact that Emmanuel Sanders had on the young receivers in San Francisco, Chris. From Bourne to Dante Pettis to Deebo Samuel, and that influence is going to linger. We've got more PFT Live coming at you right after.
Hi, I'm Mike Tirico, and thanks for watching. Make sure to hit subscribe for the latest news and highlights from NBC Sports.